Right, come here. We're going to do some dollying today. As you've seen, last few weeks there, guys, we've had all that material sitting off to the side in front of the shed there. And all that material, well, we've got a lot of gold out of it. A lot of gold. Grams and grams of gold. But everything that we haven't crushed up properly, we've just sort of sat off to the side. And, well, we've got a few different samples and materials there. As you see in the pan there, we've got, in the dustpan, we've got type of slaty sandstone material. And over in the black pan here, the actual gold pan, we've got a real quartzy type blend material. So what we're going to do is crush them both up. We've been waiting for this. As I said, there was a pile sitting there. It's now in the pans, in the dustpan and the gold pan. We are going to dolly it up. And another bit of a method that I've got is cutting this little bucket open on the bottom and basically placing him there. And you just pour all your material onto the concrete and you smash it up on the concrete. Because what I find happens in the dolly pot, you load it up too much and, well, it doesn't actually break up the material on the bottom. You're just breaking up the material that's sitting on the top, and you're forever taking the plunger out, the hammer out, shaking it around and trying to shake those heavies to the top again and smash it down again. So the dolly pot works well, but the concrete also works just as good. The last sample we've got is this sample here, and I'm going to zoom in on this one because it's a really interesting piece of stone. And he's got the slate and the sandstone mixed all in together there. You can see that. He looks like he's got a few little quartz crystals in there too. But he's also got this ironstone hanging around the back here. So we are going to dolly that one up separate. And this one had no visible gold in it per se. However, what I want to see, does it have microscopic gold? Does it have flower gold? Were the miners busting up all the stone there in this area? Because in this area, it's a real sandstony area. It's black rock sandstone. Sedimentary layer, and the gold is coming out from the sandstone and mixed in with the quartz, but mainly the sandstone. So what I sort of want to question with this stone is, were the miners breaking it all up and getting, you know, particles of gold in every stone, or were they just getting what they could visibly see hanging out the side? That's what we're going to test with that stone. But these other piles here, we're just going to smash them up, pan them off, and see how much gold we've got, how we can get out of them. So let's make a start. Well, happy with that. That's crushed up enough, the first sample there, and it's into a dust. We classified it down, as you can see, everything but the remaining little sample. So the little last little bit we just finished off in the dolly pot, and look, there's some few bits there that could be crushed up more, but that'll do. We're going to go pan him off now. We've got a nice, fresh, clean bucket of water outside waiting. We'll test sample number one, and then we'll get back and crush sample number two and test that as well. Rightio, well, there we go. We've got you out in the sun now. We can all see the gold that we've got. Two little specks. One of them actually is a picker too. We can pick him up. Oh, can pick him up. That's cool. I knew we were going to get some gold out of it. That's a great little result right there. Two little gold nuggets. I actually thought we'd get a little bit more smaller stuff, like finer flower gold. But look, that's awesome. Two little nuggets. Now let's see what the quartz has to offer. Righto, quartz is to a dust, and I will say, you got to be careful. Do this in a ventilated space or wear a mask, because quartz is basically silica, and silica is what killed a lot of the miners back in the day. So when you're crushing up quartz especially, you need to be careful. Even my phone is dusty from sitting there just recording all this. So make sure you wear a mask or do it outside on a nice breezy day. Make sure you're not inhaling the fumes and all the dust coming up when you're crushing quartz. Let's get outside now. Let's pan it. Rightio, well, result number two, and that blows my mind. It really does. The quartz is holding majority of the gold in this scenario, and that's not the case with most other scenarios that we've seen. We've seen that the sandstone in this area is holding most of the gold. So maybe we had a little rich bit of quartz there, because we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 pieces, and what's really interesting too, I don't know how this got in here, we've got a little bit of lead by the looks. I think that's what it is. I'm going to zoom you right in. But I just scraped him off on the concrete there. And he sort of scrapes off like lead, but he sort of doesn't look like lead. He's soft though. And heavy. So interesting piece, and that ended up with all the gold. So it's obviously look a lot heavier than all the other coarser material. Just like lead, when you pan off sometimes in the creek, you'll end up with a lot of lead and a lot of black ironstone pebbles, and you know you're in the right area because they are the heavies, and where the heavies fall out, the gold falls out. So what a great result. What an interesting result. Let's go test that last one, the third stone, and crush it up, see what we get. Well, I am pretty astounded with these results. I really am. Let's pick him up there and put him on the end of the fingers. We've got just two, but two exceptional pieces out of that last little stone. And we couldn't see any visible gold, but there was quite clearly a gold hiding inside. So this sort of confirms my theory. Was there gold hiding in all that sandstone out at this new area? And I think there was, but to confirm that a little bit more, we're going to take some random samples next time. Just samples that, I mean, didn't sound off with the detector, because technically this stone did sound off with the detector. We brought him home, we crushed out the gold that we could see, but we left this stone that, well, we couldn't see any more visible gold. And I left it as a sample, but well, there you go. Two more bits coming out of it. So just to be interesting to take some random samples, samples that don't sound off with the detector, bring them home and crush them in future, and once again try and prove that theory. Was there gold in nearly every bit of sandstone out in this area, or was it just some bits of sandstone? As I said, stay tuned for future. We're going to prove that a little bit further. That's an exceptional result though, two bits of gold. Now let's go put it with the rest and weigh it all up and see what we had hiding in all those piles, in all that material. All right, so that was a fun little test. It really was. And to finish us off, we're going to show what we did for 1, 2, and 3. Remember, we did the slate and sandstone first. We crushed up that material that was sitting in the dustpan, and we got two little nuggets, two little bits of gold straight out of that. The second test really surprised me, because to be honest, most of the gold thus far has come from the sandstone. But with the quartz, when we crushed that up, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 11 pieces. 11 pieces of really nice gold. And the last test, which was really interesting once again, was to see if just a random bit of sandstone with the ironstone mixed through and a bit of quartz crystal had gold. And well, yes, it did. So as I said, we're going to test that theory a little bit more for future. We are going to pick up a few random pieces of sandstone and slate out in the gold fields in this area, and not where they've went off with the detector. We're just going to grab some really healthy looking pieces of sandstone and slate, and we're going to bring them home and crush them and test that theory a little bit more for future. So let's put it all on the scales. We're all itching to see just how much gold was sitting on the shed floor. Wayne Armstrong actually said there the other week, he's going to come around and sweep the shed floor. So there you go, mate. This is all the gold that you would have got had you come around and done so. We've got 0.14 on the scales. And the last one brings us to, not much more, 0.14. So look, really great results, and probably what, 15, 16 bits of gold in there. Really exceptional. I think the scales have been a bit funny. Oh, there you go, 0.17. And this is all the gold that we got in the last 8 days hunting. Quite an exceptional result there once again. All in this sandstone slaty type area. I'm just going to pull the gemstone out because he doesn't belong in there. But that's really cool too. We found him in the side of a mullock heap. And I do believe with all the inclusions and imperfections that you can see in that stone, I'm thinking that it's real. Just going to zoom in there, see if you'll pick him up. Been a bit funny there. Camera's been really funny. We'll go in again. Nah, it's not happening, sorry. But really, really cool little stone, and I put him on the loop there, and I said I could see little imperfections in that stone. So adding all our rest of our gold for the month of May, brings us to 4.75 grams. So once again, exceptional result, and look, that is a great start to the month of May. We're only halfway through, and we've got a lot more gold hunting in this area to come yet. So I hope you've enjoyed, and we'll be crushing up more stones, so make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. Follow our adventures for future. Cheers.